Hello and welcome to Asian Voices, your source for Asian and Pacific Islander culture, lifestyle, and entertainment in Southern California. I'm your host, Kathleen Choi. We recently met with an extraordinary writer, director, and actor whose life's mission is to promote a better awareness and understanding of the Japanese-American experience through his powerful live theater plays, documentaries, and feature films. Lane Nishikawa's inspiring work often focuses on poignant subjects ranging from the struggle for Japanese Americans to find their own identity in our society today, to the historical irony of Japanese American soldiers becoming World War heroes in World War II and being honored only years later, while over 100,000 other Japanese American families were placed in internment camps for the duration of the same war.
I brought something. You wanted to bring it home to you. Freddy gave his life for me. Least I could do was deliver it for him.
Thank you.
As a writer, what you're trying to do is change society's opinion of who we are. I think what propels prejudice, racism, a lot is fear and ignorance. So the more that I can educate them about who we are as, you know, a community, as a people, the more they know about us culturally and understand us, I think that then, you know, there's more acceptance. And that's what I try to do with my work. Only the Brave is a story of the 142nd Nisei Japanese American Regiment, who rescued the 1st Battalion of the Texans, the 141st Regiment, when they were cut off behind enemy lines in October of 1944 in the Vosges Forest of France. There were two regiments of Nazis that had cut them off. And the 141st, their regiment, and their sister regiment, the 143rd, two Texas regiments, fought for 5 days to try and reach them with no success. So they were pulled back. Then they sent in the 100442. They fought for 4 days. They reached the Texans, and they saved 211 of the 275 men. But in those 4 days of fighting, they suffered over 800 casualties of their own. That's a story behind Only the Brave. One of the organizations that I help is the San Diego Japanese American Citizens League. And 2 years ago in 2015, we wanted to do something where we commemorated the 70th anniversary of the end of World War II. Many of the board members, their fathers, were 442 or MIS, Military Intelligence Service. So we decided to interview as many of the soldiers that were left. San Diego had 118 Nisei soldiers, and there were only a handful left. And so we were able to get a few of them on tape, but I also wanted to interview the wives, the sisters and brothers, the sons and daughters, and the grandchildren, and talk about what their service meant to their lives today. That's never forget. And so we were able to complete that documentary this last year, and we're just starting to show it around San Diego, and we're going to eventually show it around the country.
Japanese Americans serving in the Military Intelligence Service, the MIS, received their training at the Presidio Army Base in San Francisco and later Camp Savage, Minnesota, sending over 3,000 Nisei to almost every U.S. military unit in the Pacific Campaign.
How do you describe what you went through?
It was tough. You know, Because you never knew when you were going to die.
Again, with the help of the San Diego JCL, it's called Our Lost Years, and it is focused on the internment of the Japanese Americans. This year, 2017, is the 75th anniversary of Executive Order 9066. Roosevelt signed that executive order, President Roosevelt, that sent the Japanese into the internment camp. And so I think it is very appropriate that we really take a look at what happened 75 years ago, because it is being brought up today in our political climate of what's going on in the world. As an Asian American, if you take a look at one of my films, I hope that you embrace your history and embrace your past. As a non-Asian, I hope you learn something. And I hope you look past our face and into who we are as people. And I think that that's something that, again, it's interesting. Our next gala for the San Diego Japanese American Citizens League is called One Nation. And it's because we're looking at a time where being so divisive, you know, politically. So what we have to do is really come together as a nation. We also have to come together as a people. And so I think that's what I hope the work I do helps to do, that brings us together versus pushing us apart. I'm Lane Nishikawa, and this is my voice.